guys, welcome back to this new video. In this video we will make an advanced NPC. I think it's gonna be more than two or more than three videos, I'm not sure yet, because it is very advanced and I will explain and just make sure it works for you guys as well in the videos that come along. So I will explain what this NPC will do. Let me first ungroup this quickly. There we go. So in config here, you can eventually change the attack damage. That's basically the damage that this NPC does to you. The attack radius. So if you are 60 studs, so let me spawn in a part. Make 60 by 1 by 60. So in this radius, he will attack me. So if I walk here, it will attack me. Destroy undead, so if it will destroy undead and never comes back, else it will respawn each 5 seconds, that I will also make. Portal enable, basically it will walk around, as you can see right here. It will walk around a little bit, not to make it just stand here out of nothing. Portal radius, so the radius it walks portal on. You can also make this 1000 and it will portal everywhere, to make it more random. And Ragdoll enabled, basically it will, when it dies, it will be realistic basically. Also have animation, the attack animations that you can change. You can change the way it attacks you, and the death animation, so the Ragdoll animation basically. What can you also change? Let me see. I will script this with you guys. So you can also add a delay, and then it will destroy the NPC when it's dead. The portal walk speed, so the walk speed when it is just walking around. The min reposition time and the max reposition time is basically when you are away, when you walk away and you have a distance between you and him, it will wait 2 to 10 seconds before it goes back to its original place, what is right here where it is right now. What is also in the future, max parts per heartbeat, that's just the stats, attack stand time. The hitbox size, search delay, attack range, attack delay, attack minimum wall speed and a max wall speed. It basically makes sense. You can also change more, but that is more in these type of scripts, but I will explain every one of them as well. In this tutorial I will give away a lot of scripts, so let me first show you a preview right now. As you can see, it walks behind me, and when I am in a certain distance, it will stop following me. There you go, it goes back to its original place. There we go, and it stops, and then it will go in patrol mode. Basically, as you can see, it just walks around a bit. When it attacks me, you see it has a really bad fighting animation, but you can make your own much advanced one. And say we kill it. There we go, nice animation, and it respawns because I think. Let me see. Okay, it's dead now. Let me see if it respawns. Not sure. No, I don't think so. Okay, so let me see if that actually works real quick. Destroy on dead. Oh yeah, let's turn it off. There we go. Oh yeah, no. It won't respawn, it just stays like this. Dead on the ground. My bad. But I can maybe make a tutorial if you guys want on how to make that. Okay, let's first spawn in a NPC, go to plugins. And if I'm right, you can see a build wig kind of plugin. Then press R15, block wig, there we go. Now let's remove the name, and I remove the face always, and then let's, you can of course customize this the way you want it. There we go. More NPC, let's color these ones real quick. Like brownish, I think. Now let's just make it blue like this. There we go. Let's also change the upper torso and the these arms. Can try. Yeah, there we go. Just a bad costume, but it will work. Okay, let's first add a folder and let's call it animations. Animations. There we go. Inside the animations, I will paste in my animations. The first one is called attack animation and dead animation. You can copy this ID right here. Dead animation and the attack animation. I wouldn't recommend using mine because mine is kind of trash. Okay. Then have in the initial poses. I will paste this in the video description. There we go. Yeah, perfect. Now let's inside this humanoid. I will paste a animator NPC. So just go right click insert object animation. Let's call it animator. And yeah. Wait, it's not an animation. It is a what is it called again? Let me see. I think it's just no, it is an animation. Property animator. Oh, it's an animator. Yeah, animator. There we go. You can just add it into your script. Okay, then basically put a animation for script. Animation. No. I'm bad. I will also paste this into the description of the game. Animate with all these animations. Play mode as well. There we go. This animation basically will animate this character the way we want it. And last but not least, configuration. Just add a configuration folder. Configuration, there we go. And inside this configuration folder, add a number value called attack damage and change that to the amount you want it to damage you as a player. Attack radius, again a number value, and this is the attack radius. In the radius it will attack you. Destroy undead, it is a bool value. Its value can be on and off. If you turn it on, it will destroy undead. If not, it will stay there. Patrol enabled, it's also a bool value. And make the turn on if you want it to walk around with the radius, that is a number value. And this will be the radius it will walk around in the patrol. Enabled. The vector enabled is also a boo value and turn it on if you want it to be realistic. There we go. That's basically what we need right now. And oh no, one more thing is the Roblox sound. You don't need this, but I recommend it. It will just make the footsteps and stuff much more cleaner. You can also change those sounds on the way you want it. Then we are gonna add a NPC script. There we go. Script. NPC. There we go. And inside the NPC, we will first do local collection surface. Is game dot. No, get surface. Collection surface. There we go. Local run surface. Is game. Dot get surface again and then run surface. Run surface. There we go. Local workspace is game. Oh, there we go. Game get surface again. Workspace. Local ragdoll is require script. Wait for child. Doll. There we go. Perfect. Let me. Yes. Okay. Then, do local mate is require script dot wait for child mate. There we go. Local function. Get. Let me zoom in a little bit. Get value from config name local configuration. It's script apparent. Wait for child. Configuration. There we go. Local value object is configuration and configuration. Find first child name. This is all basically just to set up the positions of every single thing. Return value object and value object dot value. And there we go, and now we can just move this. Not worry about this yet. Let me see if I wrote it right. Yes. Name, perfect. Now, so don't worry about. Oh, wait. Local function. There you go. I bet. Then local. Okay, now we put in the configure damage is get value from config attack. Attack damage. So now we are getting all the config things. So it will basically save that data into this script that can eventually make the attack damage, attack radius work. So let's do that. Attack damage, just copy paste this. There we go, and call this attack radius. Radius, there we go. And then radius. Make sure you wrote it exactly like this. So radius. There we go. Cool. Local patrol enabled. Enable is get value from config. Patrol enabled. There we go. Local patrol radius. Make sure to not forget the text, and then quick tool enabled. Perfect. Then local death destroy the lay. Okay, I will do all these settings. So see you soon. Welcome back. So as you can see right now, I have put in all the settings. You can change all these. So the dead delay, the delay when it will die, the walk speed on patrol enabled, the reposition time, the max parts per heartbeat, just make that 50. Attack stand time, this is the hitbox size. Don't change this as well. I mean, you can change it. It's all basically the hitbox size of when it will attack. Search delay, you can just leave this on 1, I recommend. The attack range, so the range when it can attack you and damage you. The attack delay, so if you make this 0.1, it will attack each 0.1 second. The min walk speed and the max walk speed. You can change all these. And of course, all these in the folder. Perfect. Now we are gonna add the made script, what will be very useful. Let's add that. And you can see as I you can just copy this script in your script. It's pretty useful that will be used later in the part. Now we are gonna add more state settings. So yeah, let's do that. Okay, we added a lot of state attacks. The attacking, it will first be false, and when it is in the radius, it will be true. At least we are gonna make that. The search for targets is false, because it ain't searching for targets yet, but when you are in the attack radius, it will search for the target. That will be you, or any other player who is also in that radius. And just make these nil, search index 0, time search ended 0. This is just the default time, basically. It's all the default, and when something happens, it will change this. So yeah, very good. We make good progress. Let me show you there. We go. Now we are gonna add some animations. So let's add that. Oh, yo guys, welcome back. So in this local value, make sure to make this capital workspace. That was my bad. So yeah, this is the new script. You can just edit. It'll basically add the attack animation and the death animation to the script. You can also turn this on true if you want the attack animation to be looped. I don't recommend it because I recommend it just attacking when it is near you. Also, it will just loop attacking. That doesn't really make sense. You can also loop the death animation, but will also not make any sense because then it will die and die each time. So yeah, now we are gonna add the random function, but will be very, very useful. It will be a helper function. So first, let's add what is it called again? Oh yeah, comment and just do a helper function. This will just basically tell us where a helper function is. So this is the first start on it. As you can see right now, it has some width lines on it, but won't be any problem yet. So yeah, this is will basically is alive and destroy if it is dead. So if made, basically the NPC is dead, then it will destroy itself if it is turned on. That's why we call it in a function that will only call when we turned dead on, destroy and dead on. And this is just to make sure it is alive and not do anything random, like destroying the NPC when there's no need for it to destroy, because it might not even be dead. So that's just to make sure that bit. Then let's add the next part of the script. So I see you guys soon. Okay, now we are adding a lot of new code, as you can see. So you can pause the video over here. Basically what this will do, it will basically, the magnitude is the search radius, as you can see. Where can we see that again? Target is the instance, so target's radius is to find the first dealt humanoid. We are the humanoid, so it will find the nearest humanoid inside this target's position. Magnitude is basically the radius of, so say we are in this square box, that is the magnitude of the square radius. So it will just make sure that it will attack when we are in that magnitude radius. Say we add another NPC, that will also make sure that this does. Let me explain. So when we add another NPC like this, it with the same name humanoid, but it will know that this will be a friendly humanoid. So this guy won't attack this guy. Now we add find the target, so now it can actually find us. This function ain't done yet, but this will basically calculate the center position of this NPC, what is just the humanoid root part. And from there on, it will make a box around itself that you won't see, and that will be the search radius. Okay, now we have the function finished, as you can see right here. I will just go by it very slowly so you can pause it at each time. This is just basically to finish up the search for targets function. Perfect. So this will be the end of this video. In the next video, we will finish this script and add some module scripts that will calculate everything for us. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.